Hello everyone, today we are going to start a new chapter, okay? Chapter 3, that is force and pressure. Now, first of all, let me tell you what are the things which are going to discuss in this chapter and what the things which you need to learn. First of all, what you have studied till now is just about the force. That is, whenever a push and pull is applied to an object, that means that is the force, that is the force applied to an object, and with the help of the push and pull, the object will tend to move from one place to another. That is what we have studied. But there is much more than that to this topic, that is force. So in this chapter, what we are going to study is the turning effect of force. With the force, an object will turn. Not only it will move in a straight line, but if it is an object, if you move a force, then it will turn. It will turn from, it will not only move, it will turn. So with all these things which we are going to study are those things which we are going to study in this chapter. So let us start with the basic topic, that is the first one in this chapter is force. Now, we have already read that body which does not change its position with respect to its surrounding is said to be at rest. So if a body is at one place, it's not changing its position, then we say that the body is in rest. If a body is moving from one place to another, then we say that the body is in motion. But that motion doesn't happen by itself. There is some sort of force which is providing the motion. Force is a cause which tends to result in movement or change in size or shape of a body. So what force can do is, force can either change the place of an object, it can make the object move, or either it can change the shape of an object. So force can do, force can change the shape or change the position. The other thing is, the force when applied as push or pull on a stationary body which is free to move can produce motion in it, and if applied on a moving body, it can change the speed of a body. So if a body is at rest, okay, if body is at rest, you keep an object in the table, if you apply some force, the object tends to move. That is one thing. Another thing is, if an object is already moving, for example, a car which is already moving in the road. If you apply force, that means if you accelerate the car, then what happens? The car will move with more speed. So force can either increase the speed or either it can make a stationary body move. That is all those things. Now there are a few examples. Let us understand those examples. Okay, the first one is, a grass roller initially at rest when pulled begins to move. I hope many of you have seen this grass roller. It is basically used in the field to level the land, okay, the surface of the land, or either to pull the seeds down towards the earth. So what happens when you pull the grass roller, when you apply some force, that grass roller which is stationary will move with the help of the force. And what is applying the force? Our body, we are applying the force. That is, when applying a force, an object tends to move. That is the first example. Second one is, a fielder which when catches a ball stops the moving ball. A fielder example can be, when you are playing football, a goalkeeper, when a ball moves towards his side, when he holds the ball, when he catches the ball, what happens is, he tends to stop the moving ball. The ball which is already moving, it will come to a stop. So force when applied can stop a moving object. Third one is, a moving car slows down on applying brakes on it. So applying some force, a moving car can stop. So force can either make a body move or either it can make a moving body stop. Third is, a push on a swinging girl speeds up her speed. So if a girl is playing swing, so if you apply some force, then what happens? Will move with higher speed. So force can either increase the speed. Okay, these are a few examples. So when force is applied as stretch or squeeze on a body which is not free to move, then it changes the size or shape of a body. For this, take an example of a rubber band. Simple example, a rubber band. If you hold it in your hand and pull from both the sides, then what happens? It is a solid, but it doesn't change its position. It doesn't move from one place to another place. It doesn't move along a line. What happens? The shape of that rubber band will change. Another example can be slime. If you apply some force to a slime, then what happens? The shape of the slime will change. So when applying a force, not only it changes its position, but the shape of that object can also be changed. So example of changing shape is, there are two examples given in the book. On stretching a rubber band, rubber string, its length increases. So we know that on pulling a rubber band, what happens? The length of the rubber band will increase. As soon as we leave that, it comes to its original position. So on applying force, the length of the rubber band can be changed. Second one is, on squeezing a tube of gum, its shape changes. So when you squeeze on the tube of a gum, okay, that also changes the shape of that tube. Other basic examples are while making jewelries. If you have ever seen that process, what they do is they heat an object, gold, silver, whatever it is, then they apply force to it. On applying the force to the jewelry, what happens? The shape of the jewelry, the gold, can be changed and you can make it in a desired shape. So with the help of a force, the shape of an object can be changed. So the definition of the force is given in the box. You need to mark that, and with that definition, that will be the answer for the first question. Please listen carefully. It's given in question answers are given in page number 56. Okay, page number 56, short long answer question. First one is to define force. So for that one, the answer is there in page number 38 inside the box, which is force is that cause which changes the state of a body, or it changes the size or shape of a body. So that will be the definition of force. Okay, with that, there is inside a box, we can read that, do you know? The speed of a body is defined as a distance traveled by it in 1 second. So it is a formula of speed. We'll learn it in the second or third chapter. Now, there is note over there. Number one, a force does not change the mass of a body on which it is applied. So things we need to remember is, even though we apply a force on any object, the position of the object might change, but the weight of that object, mass of that object. If you apply a force on this duster, hardly it is of 10 grams. If you apply a force on this duster, what happens? This 10 gram of a duster will move from one point to another, but the mass present in the duster, which is 10 gram, will not reduce, neither it will increase. It will remain the same. Second one is, we cannot see a force, however, we can see or feel the effect of the force. So force is something invisible, which cannot see a force. But what we can see is how the force is affecting an object, how it is changing the size, shape, or the position of that object. Third one is, a force is expressed by stating both its magnitude and direction. Important thing which you need to remember is, force is a vector quantity. This you have already learned, scalar and vector. Scalar is which only has magnitude but doesn't have any direction. But vector is something, a physical quantity which has direction as well as magnitude. So force has magnitude. Force can be measured. You know how much force? Force can be more, force can be less. Force can be measured. And force also has a direction. Force can be applied in a particular direction. Example, gravitational force is towards the earth. So the four direction of gravitational force is downward. Okay. Now, we'll also learn about unit of force. If you have to measure something, if you have to measure any physical quantity, then what we need is the unit. Most important thing we need to remember is the unit. So as we know, unit of mass is kilogram, unit of distance is meter. So in the same context, unit of force will be Newton. Unit of force is Newton. Sorry, this N will be small. And whenever we write Newton, we write this way. And if you just write the symbol, then we write capital N. So this is how we write the unit of force. So we cannot just say it is one force, two force. We have to say specifically either it is 1 newton or 2 newton so on. So this will be the force on a particular object. So I guess you know who was Newton, and he has a lot of contribution of the discovery of gravitational force and so on. That is why on his name, with due respect, we have given the unit of force as Newton. Now, 1 Newton is defined as the force which, when applied on a moving body of mass 1 kg in the direction of its motion, increases its speed by 1 meter per second in 1 second. So, I'll just explain you this. If we have a mass of 1 kg, if we have an object of 1 kg, then we apply some force to this. We push this object. Then what happens? This object will move with the speed. If this object moves with the speed of 1 meter per second, please carefully look at the values. If the object is 1 kg, we apply some force, it moves with the speed of 1 meter per second. Now, if the object is moving with 1 meter per second and the object is 1 kg, then the force which is applied over here is said to be 1 Newton. Then the force is 1 Newton. Okay, this is how you define 1 Newton of force. Okay, now we have read that our Earth attracts each body towards it. We already know that there is a gravitational force. With the help of the gravitational force, we are being able to walk on the surface of the Earth, because there is some force which is attracting it towards itself. The force of attraction exerted on the body by Earth is called the weight of the body. So there are different names. We generally are confused between weight and mass, but they are totally opposite things. It is not either related. Okay, so weight is actually the force. Weight of a body is the force exerted by the Earth. So the gravitational force has different name. One, it can be called as weight of the body. Another, it can be called as force of gravity. Okay, that will be the force with which the Earth is pulling everything downward. Now the force of gravity, the gravitational force which is there in the Earth, is not same at every point in the Earth. Okay? If you go to different places, then the gravitational force is a bit different. Not drastically different, but with a small value, it is a bit different. It's not the same. Okay. Now, one unit you have already learned about force is Newton. There is another unit which you need to remember, okay, that is you have an object 1 kg. If a force is applied to this object, okay, if you apply some force to this object, then that force will be 1 kgf. 1 kgf, or we can read it as 1 kilogram force. Okay, this is the other unit of force. And 1 kg of force, generally we study how to relate Newton and this. So 1 kg of force is equals to 10 Newton. You need to remember this, because afterwards we need to do some numerics. Okay? Just remember the conversion. 1 kgf is equals to 10 Newton. Sometimes in numerical, the value of force is given in terms of kgf. We need to convert sometimes into Newton. So we use this conversion. And the detail of all these things, why it is this, we will study in higher classes. Okay? Because right now you might not be able to understand this in depth and detail. Okay, in page number 39, there is a box where you can read, do you know? The first one is, a body in which the interspacing between its constituent particles do not change when the force is applied is called a rigid body. So, whenever we apply a force, take an example of a stone, a smaller stone. If you apply some force to the stone, what happens is, it will change its position. The shape of the stone cannot be changed because the force will not be enough. So what does is, it will change its position, it will move. So that object whose the structure, the shape does not change is known as a rigid body. And there is just an opposite which is known as non-rigid body. Example, slime. If you apply some force to a slime, what happens? The shape of that slime will change. The slime is considered to be a non-rigid body. Okay, these are the things, these are the basic things of this chapter. Remember the definition, the unit of the force, and 1 kgf is equals to 10 newton. This is what you need to remember. With this, you will solve the questions. Question number 1, 2 and 3. There are 3 questions which you need to solve. Number 1 is define force. Another one is state 2 effects on a force, effects of a force when applied on a body. So that will be the effect on a force when we apply the force is, it will either the state of the object will change, it will be either in motion or in rest. Or second thing is, either with the help of the force, the size and the shape of the object will change. These are the 2 effects. You can find it in the definition itself. Third one is, how does the effect of a force differ when it is applied on a rigid body? This we have just discussed. That is, when we apply force on a rigid body, the body will move from one place to another. So, when applied on a non-rigid body, the shape of that body will change. So what, with the help of this discussion, you can solve these questions. Okay, so this much for today. We will continue in the next class. Thank you.